Hey, what's up guys, it's Mac here again with another PC build video, and today we're going to create a white MATX APU build. This is a part of our budget PC building project for productivity and light gaming. We will do some overclocks in this build, so if you're interested in seeing its performance, stay tuned and watch the video. So here are the parts list. First, the star of the build, the Ryzen 2200G with Vega graphics. No matter how you look into this, this is the best bang for the buck CPU at its price range by the time we're making this video. And here's the motherboard. When I first built on MSI B450 Bazooka, a lot of people in Facebook groups are asking me to just go for MSI B450M motor or Tomahawk instead. So I decided to go with titanium version, since we're going to do a white build, sort of. This is a little bit expensive than the black version, but it has almost the same specs if I'm not mistaken. Well, if you want to see some detailed specification, just check this out and pause the video. So inside the box, there is the motherboard itself, the I/O shield, the CD driver, MSI logo sticker, 2 SATA cable, 2 M.2 screw, the manual, and some documentations. For the memory, I pick up some Crucial Ballistics 2x4GB with 2666MHz. From what I've heard, this is the most affordable RAM sticks you could overclock. So let's see if we could overclock this to 3000MHz. And for the boot drive, we'll be using the Kingston 240GB M.2 SSD. I'm not so sure about its performance, but it has good reviews from where I purchased this from. And it's a bit cheaper than the WD Green 240GB M.2 we used in the last build video. This is not included in the budget, but we might as well use it instead of just accumulating dust inside my office. So we will be adding a WD Blue 320GB hard drive. This will just cost you around $18 in Amazon. For the power supply, we'll be using Corsair's VS450. Since we are not using any GPU, this one is more than enough for our build. It is a non-modular PSU with 80+ watt, so I guess we can be confident with our overclocks. And for the case, we'll be using a local brand called Rakk Anyag, which costs around $30. This is a white MATX case with real tempered glass panel. It has a rubber holder for mounting the tempered glass side panel. The pegs for this side panel are very large and easy to use. Included in the box are 3 Velcro straps, screws for motherboard, fans, power supply, and even radiator screws are included. Unfortunately, there is no single fan included in this case. Since we don't have any fans, we decided to go with PC Cooler Corona. It costs around $30 as well, with 3 pieces of 120 fans in the package. It is made out of a sturdy plastic with hydraulic bearing and RGB features. Inside the package, we have some screws for all of the fans, 1 fan splitter, 1 RGB splitter, 1 RGB controller in Molex if your motherboard doesn't have any RGB connector, and some documentations. With all that said and done, let's just enjoy this B-roll. If you wanted to see a time-lapse build, please check out the card on your screen. But as of now, we will do some overclocking. So we set the CPU game boost on in the BIOS, and it automatically boosts our CPU to 3.75 GHz in 1.4 volts. As for the APU GFX speed, it automatically boosts from 400 MHz to 1100 MHz. And for the memory, we were able to place a stable 3000MHz. All we have to do now is just to apply it, restart the PC, and run some stress tests for 30 minutes before playing some games. But of course, I will not show you the stress test process since it will take too long. So let's just jump to the gameplays. final thoughts. First, the building process. It is not as smooth like we have using the Q300L case. This case, Rakk Anyag, has the worst spacing and unnecessary stuff happening inside the chassis. Number one problem is the cable management spacing. It has some cable management points, but it doesn't have enough clearance for the cables themselves. Second problem is the case front panel. It has this unnecessary foam attached on the mesh. This will just prevent the airflow, so I ended up removing it. If its purpose is just to be a dust filter, it's not really going to cut it. Nobody uses a foam for a dust filter. Third problem is the front IO panel is connected to the front cover. Cleaning it in the future is going to be a pain since you need to remove all of the wiring connected to the motherboard before you'll be able to remove the front panel. Well, this is a budget case, so I guess we're just getting what we paid for. As for the other parts, everything is working well, other than this case. On the overclocking side, using the game boost in the BIOS is the easiest way to overclock the system, but it turns out that the APU GFX speed is only up to 1100 MHz. Wherein in the last video, we were able to get a stable 1300 in the same voltage. However, the performance of this build is way better than our previous build. Overall, I love the build, aesthetically and performance outcome. So that's it guys, if you're interested in building the same specs, please check out the parts list in the description below and use the links to buy for yourself today. Thanks guys for watching and we'll see you in the next episode.